the fruit of my emotions stem from foreign soil, and that's where I long to be, in the land where rich traditions reside. No, it's not mine, and yes, it is his, but nonetheless, the space next to him is where I want to dwell in. Crack kunk or fritters, peace and rice with group of macaroni and cheese, I wasn't used to, but my mouth now wears. My insides have a need. I long to taste the sweetness of his guava duff or the reminiscent taste of chicken sauce. These thoughts bring back the hunger, similar to the one that led me to devour his skin. I miss him. These emotions boiling inside of me come from the pink sand I never stood in. But I was fortunate enough to swim in the pure waters of his islands, to drive to West End, to the peak of his dwelling on dark nights that were lit only by the plethora of stars I never saw in Miami, became symbolic of the nights I climaxed while he was inside of me. With land so green and the sea pristine, his ocean surrounded my planet. He became the source of my existence as I planned a future in the soil that keeps him grounded. The tamarind tree, a nice little old school joint that played tunes from early reggae and soca to soul and calypso. It exposed our mature youth. See, we grew together. We became dreamers of love within ourselves, with the thought that nothing else can ever intervene between us. No time nor distance, not people nor silence. Bathing in his ocean, he baptized me with his culture. I was introduced to Junkanoo, vibrant colored costumes worn by passionate characters who smiled down streets during festivities. Lyrically and rhythmically embracing rake and scrape, the beatings on the goombe drums pounded in our hearts as the songs that were strained to create wobbly melodies shaped our souls like Rosa's melodic beauty encompassed passion. With emotion, our souls harmonized in a world where evil can easily prevail. We were ready to create personal folk tales to our own music. Acoustic sounds accurately represented our union, pure, like honey snatched directly from the comb. See, together we dreamt of traveling the world. And whether it was the quietude of Freeport or the noisy streets of Nassau, this home became my own. Thank you.